Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor.
You're listening to Game Day on Typha Radio, part of the Typha Sports Network. And now with the call, Kenny Long.
And welcome to our second game of the day. It's a single matchup between San Antonio Kenny Barons and the Southside Bulls out of the Houston chapter. And we just finished up with our first game of the day out of Senior Day. 70 to break down small to the Texas Giants by a score of 19-8. Again, no rosters for these games. I'm not doing any rosters for any games. So we're just going to be calling out numbers. So I hope you know your loved one's number. Looks like the Southside Colts will receive the football going up the right. Colts, they're in a green over yellow with green helmets, yellow trim. Barons in their classic purple. Classic black and purple. And here's the kick. And it'll be a split kick here on the near side. We put that number 10 for the Colts. Spins out of one tackle. Comes here to the near sidelines. Body was grabbed up, taken down. That's going to be first down for the Colts. So spot the ball about the 48-yard line. Wednesday night, the zone here on Typha Radio. Every Wednesday starting at 8 p.m. We'll recap this Wednesday, the 2017 Spring Bowl here, and all the events going on in McAllen, Texas. Welcome. If you haven't joined us, you're missing some great football. Great day. It's sunny skies. We've got a few popcorn clouds up and above, but it's hot. It's got a hot breeze, but we're having a great time. Hands off. Comes here to the inside of the 7. Good hit. Number 42 for the Barons. Number 7 is quite the load, but cannot get past the defensive line of the Barons. It'll be up second down. Give him about a 1 yard gain on that play. We'll run down some scores we've gotten so far from around the tournament. Under center, empty backfield, man in motion from the near side, take the snap, hands off to the motion, man number 1. Cuts inside and he gets tripped up, taken down, and not before he gets to about the 50-yard line. And that's exactly where they'll spot him at, is the 50. Third down coming up here for the Colts. So far, the leaders of the score have been reported to me in the flag division. The Texas Giants defeat the Southwest Houston Junior Marlins 18-0. Giants will move on to face either the Katy Texans or the Tri-County Titans. And in the midget division, Littlefield loses to the Katy Texans. Texans will play the Lone Star Rebels at 1:30 on Field 8. No report out of the rookie level yet. In the junior level, Southwest Houston Junior Marlins defeat the Junior Marlins 48-0. They move on to face either the Lone Star Rebels or the Katy Texans. Handoff comes in on the near side, gets tripped under the line
on the carry for the Colts. It's going to bring up fourth down.
Also, the junior level, Texas Bad Boys defeat the Tri-County Titans 21-13. They move on to face out of the Mission Mustangs or True Blue out of San Antonio. And of course, out of the senior level, we already told you the Texas Giants defeat the San Bernardino Greyhounds 19-8 as they move on to face the winner between the Harlem Chicago and the Houston Seahawks. Fourth down play coming up. Defense! Defense! The Baron face cut. Takes a snap. Hands off on the one. Look at the pass. They're setting up the far side of the football field. They got a man and overthrows. He's intended to shoot at number 2. That's going to be a turnover on downs. First down for the Barons. Our next game here on Field 6 is scheduled for 12 o'clock. Tri-County Titans and the Cypress Titans. 1:30, we've got those Huntington Cardinals and the Houston Seahawks and the Steelers. Shotgun for the Bears. Takes a snap, hands it off, comes in the near side, cuts in off tackle. And fights off some tackle. So he gets there, he'll get the first down. As he takes it about the 36-yard line. Number 13 on the carry for the Barons. Look at these junior Barons in the little machine. They look really small. But good hard running, good blocking up front. Takes a snap, hands it off number three this time. Over to the far side, now cuts inside, breaks one tackle, he'll get wrapped up, taken down. And he'll lose some yardage on that play on first down as they'll back him up to about the 38-yard line. Second down for the Barons. Takes a snap, steps back, looking to pass. He'll set it up here to his side, but behind his intended receiver, number 12. That'll be about third down for the Barons. Snap out of the shotgun, hands it off to his tailback at 21. He'll cut inside, a crushing him at 13, and a nice run. He'll take it past the legal line of scrimmage. At the 28-yard line, where they'll spot him at fourth down, so we call it about a fourth and a long two. Sprint back to it, takes the snap, hands it off again. 13, fight his way forward, and he'll get the first down and a little bit more. So Barron's moving the football well. Timeout called by the Colts. They need to talk it over. Pissed up and let them have that talk to you. We'll have back your line. Tiger Radio's coverage of the 2017 Spring Bowl.
Monarch Trophy Studio in San Antonio, a leader in the awards and recognition industry since 1972. Their mission is to provide their customers with a wide variety of high-quality, competitively priced awards. They have awards for sports, scholastics, employment, you name it, they've got it. Trophies, plaques, badges, pins, and much, much more. With the advancements in technology and the internet, Monarch Trophy Studio has quickly become one of the leading premier online award retailers. Monarch Trophy Studio is a proud sponsor of the Texas Youth Football and Cheer Association and proud provider of all TIFA awards, including the Dale Morgan Trophy. Visit Monarch Trophy Studio in their 30,000 square foot state-of-the-art production facility located at Highway 281 in Thousand Oaks in San Antonio, Texas. Contact them toll-free at 1-800-364-7903 or by email at sales@mtsawards.com. Check them out on their interactive website at www.mtsawards.com. That's mtsawards.com. Monarch Trophy Studio in San Antonio. Come get your trophy at Monarch Trophy. listening to Typho Radio on the Typho Sports Network.
Hey, welcome back. As the Bears win the football, I got messages. People had problems hearing me. It was very static when I talked. So let's see if this doesn't improve some things. All right, so I just changed some levels here. Let me know. It's a different computer I'm using, so certain things aren't set the proper way, probably, and I just changed it. So do me a favor, send me a message on Facebook Messenger, not through the Typho Radio Messenger. Go to my Facebook page and message me there. Let me know if this sounds better. If not, I can readjust from there a little bit more. It looked like my level was a little too high there. So I'll keep the dialog box open and see what I need to do to change it from there. But thanks for letting me know. That's the only way I know, but I can clear it myself on this side. Takes a snap, hands it off, hands with the football on second down. Goes off tackle here, but inside, going left to right, and he'll take it down for a good another 3-4 yards on the play on second down. First down play, they get about a 2-yard gain. So third down, they'll spot the ball about the 16-yard line. Takes a snap, hands it off. Near the near side, this time he's going to get wrapped up. And on fourth down, it'll be a turnover on downs. They don't get the first down. The ball popped out, number one for the Colts come up and start to run down the field, but they blew the whistle dead. They blew the play dead. So the Colts will take over. About the 9-0, 19-20-yard line. It's a snap. Colts with the football. Number five. They're going to cross out of the football field. Takes it down close to about 3-5. All right. So, still needs some adjusting. All right. So, we'll try this now. Is this any better? Second and 7-5, 7-6 for the Colts. Hands off, comes here to the inside, number two with the carry. And the line is good. That's a bad way. They're going to be one or two on the play, and we have third down. No change. Okay. Hang on. A few more tricks up my sleeve. All right, so we'll turn that down. Let me know if that's any better. Third down play coming up. Wait on a response here. Make sure my sound's gotten any better. If not, we'll do some more changes here. Takes the snap. Pitches it. Number 22 on the carry. Goes to the far side. Cuts upfield. Breaks one tackle. And finally gets down. He'll get the first down as he'll drive it down to about the 40-yard line of the Colts.